Greetings, everyone, and welcome to the first exciting episode of Game of Thrones. Oh boy, this one's been a long time coming. Now, I should mention, this is not the first time I've played this, so it's not going to be a blind playthrough like the Walking Dead ones were. But that said, I have not played the entire thing. I've only played about the first half of it, so from about a third of the way into episode 4 onward, it'll be all new to me as well. So, that said, I have not played it for many months. Not since, I think episode 4 was the most current episode at the time, so it's been quite a while since I originally picked this up. So, I remember bits of it, but the little nuances, well, we're basically just going to be doing it, you know, kind of going on the fly, living with the consequences of our decisions and all that fun stuff. So, I should mention, there's been some questions in the chat already about spoilers for the show. Are there any in the game? Well, the simple answer to that question is yes. There are mega spoilers in the game for the show. So if you're not caught up yet, or if you haven't ever seen the show, well, you might have a few things spoiled for you, but that said, for the most part, it is its own story that just kind of runs parallel to events from the series. In terms of the time frame, it takes place, it starts at the tail end of Season 3, and then more or less runs parallel to the events of Season 4. So there you go. So you know how far you have to watch in order to not be spoiled. Or if you don't care about spoilers and just want to enjoy the game on its own merits, let's carry on. Or if you're not planning to watch the show for a very long time and will probably have forgotten everything that was spoiled for you in this, because this is the first experience you've ever had with Game of Thrones and have no idea who any of these people are or what's going on, then more power to you. All right, so without any further ado, let us begin. All right, so I think we'll just stay down here. That should be fine. And let's get right into it, shall we? I should mention also, this was kind of my first proper experience with TellTale Games. I had heard a lot of good things about the Walking Dead games, but had not played them yet at the time. This is one of their more recent efforts, so their game system is pretty polished by this point. They really know what they're doing. I should mention also, for fans of the show, you will see a lot of characters from the show make appearances with in here, and you do interact with them quite extensively in some cases. And when those characters appear, it is the same actors who play the characters in the show doing the voices, so that's pretty cool, I gotta say. So I kind of look at this as, you know, the lost season of Game of Thrones, as it were. As far as I'm concerned, this is all canon to the main story. I don't see anything that really contradicts anything that we've seen in the show, so I'm perfectly happy to accept this as canon. Yeah, it's a good time. But yeah, so I hadn't really played any Telltale games before trying this one out, and boy, the quality of the writing and just the emotional intensity and everything really just blew me away on this. So that's why I was really eager to jump into some other games of theirs. So, and I've been really wanting to get back to this one because I want to know how it ends. So I was really, really eager to check this out. Now this I do not have on disc. I don't think it's actually been released on disc at the time of this recording. It's only available as a download. And it's available on pretty much every platform known to man. So whatever your platform of choice, go to town. Let's move that over a little bit. All right, so as you can see, I took the precaution of starting with save 2 because as you progress through the game, you see characters in the little title screen here that you don't want to see if you haven't played the game yet, because it kind of spoils things knowing that certain characters may or may not be dead and things like that, because they'll appear in this. So I made sure to have a preloaded save slot here that was basically just a new game. All right, so let's get into it here. So begin episode 1. The Northerners will never forget Tyrion Lannister. Easily one of my favorite characters from the show. Love Tyrion. I think everybody loves Tyrion, played by the always wonderful Peter Dinklage. Fantastic actor. All right. So for those of you who are all caught up on the show, this should be quite a treat for you, because you're going to recognize a lot of things from the show. I guess I'm over top of the saving icon. Whatever, you don't need that. For thousands of years, House Forrester have been loyal bannermen to House Stark. In the darkest reaches of the Wolf's Wood, they harvest the rare ironwood trees. Now the North has been ripped apart by war, and rival houses seek to claim Forrester ironwood for themselves. And the fate of House Forrester hangs in the balance. So House Forrester is another house that has been mentioned in the show and the books, but we've never really found their story before.
The great Jaime Lannister, Kingslayer, Oathbreaker, brought to his knees by the men of the North.
And set free by the women. You'd think he'd done it himself the way he tells it. Lord Forrester's sword won't clean itself, you know.
Second. Sorry, I just got to make a minor adjustment here. Settings. Sorry, I forgot. It's a fresh game, so it's... Oh, we can't adjust anything. gameplay? Yeah, this one you actually don't want the Y inverted, because it makes it really awkward to... move the crosshairs around. All right, here we go. Sorry about that, guys. Oh, that's much better. Okay, here we go.
Make sure it's spotless this time. Lord Forrester won't be happy with blood and brains all over it. Go on. It's only blood. Now that is a proper sword.
I'll have one like it myself someday.
You? You'll never have a sword like that. I say that as a friend. And if we're being honest, you are just a squire.
I will. You'll see.
Of course, your lordship. After you take your rightful place on the Iron Throne.
I had a hand in it, you know.
Hand in what?
Capturing him.
He was nowhere near the Kingslayer at the Whispering Wood. He was so drunk, he barely made it out of his tent. Next, he'll tell us he caught Tyrion, too.
Shh. Let him finish.
Oh, he'll talk all night if you let him.
You captured the Kingslayer.
Aye. Well, I had a hand in it.
Aye. And round his ankle as 10 others took him down.
See? What did I tell you?
I brought him to his knees.
Lord Forrester.
But not before he dragged you halfway across the battlefield on your face.
You're questioning Norrin's honor.
I'm questioning Norrin's story. It grows more far-fetched every time he tells it.
Get your liege lord some wine. Go on.
Right, thanks.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Garrett. I'll do it. Norrin's family has faithfully served House Forrester for centuries. His honor is beyond reproach, and House Tully is forever in his debt. They've never seen a field plowed so well as the day the Kingslayer dragged poor Norrin across the battlefield. Fetch your cup. Tonight we celebrate. To Robb Stark, the King in the North!
The King in the North!
Tomorrow, we march on Casterly Rock. And House Forrester has been given the greatest honor to lead the Young Wolf's army and ride as the vanguard.
The gods have favored us.
Onward to Casterly Rock!
Aye! Death to the Lannisters!
Aye! Iron from ice!
Aye!
Garrett.
Yes, my lord?
I need you to keep an eye out for Roderick.
As his father, I could not be more proud of the man he's become.
On a night like this, men find false courage at the bottom of their cups. I'd rather he were here.
Yes, my lord.
There's also the question of what's to be done with you.
It's been on my mind for a while now. Something must be done. You've served House Forrester well for several years now, but I can't expect you to squire forever. How shall I reward your loyalty? What can I offer you? You served me well.
To bring honor to House Forrester, my lord.
You have more honor than those who were born to it.
There were those who had their doubts when your uncle put forth your name as my squire. But you've erased those doubts entirely. It would be an honor to see you riding by Roderick's side in the vanguard tomorrow. Not as a squire, but as the equal of any man who serves House Forrester. It's well deserved, Garrett. Your hard work has paid off.
Thank you, my lord. I promise. I won't let you down.
That I don't doubt. But for now, keep this between us. We're celebrating tonight. I wouldn't want the other squires to feel discouraged.
Yes, my lord.
Now go, and find Roderick if you can.
I will, my lord. Thank you.
Bloody hell. Empty. Squire! Fetch us more wine!
Can you give me a hand? Come on. Make it up to you.
Yeah, no problem.
I have been a squire longer than you.
So?
I outrank you. You should help me.
Well, don't outrank me anymore, but... I won't rub it in your face.
Fetch more wine, scrub my armor, clean my boots. Just my luck to end up with Norin while you serve the Lord. Let him fetch his own wine for once. He's a drunk, a liar, and an arrogant prig.
You'd better watch your tongue, Bowen. It could be much worse.
What the fuck do you know about it? Nothing is worse than Norin.
See, that's where you're lucky. Low expectations. If I'd grown up covered in pig shit, shovel and slop, well, maybe I'd think saddling his horse was the greatest honor in the Seven Kingdoms.
I suppose this beats pig farming.
Who doesn't love bacon?
Pig farmers. All I'm saying is, at this rate, we'll never be more than this, which is nothing. The lowest of the low. For all I know, we could be squires for life. All in wine around a fucking wedding. What a waste of fucking time.
Give it time. You'll get there.
More easy for you to say. Maybe if my uncle were castellan at House Forrester, I'd feel different.
Who my uncle is has nothing to do with it. How much further?
It's right over there.
I just realized I was blocking that rather significant
take your time.
Title there. Sorry, I'm just going to pause for a second here. And move slightly. There we go. Sorry about that. Yeah, so the twins. And it is the night
you
of
lot have drunk
the
your
red
share.
Wedding.
Good thing Lord Walder's in a generous mood.
Fucking phrase.
Nice night for a wedding. Not often he finds a willing husband for one of his daughters.
Don't expect me to carry it for you, Sir Garrett. What's wrong? What's gotten into you? You're acting rather odd. You've had too much wine.
We need to get back. Now.
They're fine. They can wait.
No, you don't understand. We need to go.
Then take the fucking flagon already.
What's wrong with him? Something the matter?
Bowen, we have to go.
You go if you're in such a rush. But what about...
What the hell was that about? Slow down, would you? What's the rush? There's no need to fucking run. Not gonna die of thirst.
We have to warn the others.
Warn them about what?
There's no time to explain. We need to find Roderick. He's out there by himself.
To get back to camp.
Morgulis, of course. All men must die. Let's try that again, shall we?
Ready, boys! Whoa! Shoot that one!
There we go. No!
Look out!
I tried to save him, but there was nothing I could do.
Find a weapon, quickly!
Damn it. Don't give you much time.
You fucking traitor!
Go, my lord, while there's still time!
Seven hells.
We have to keep moving, my lord.
I'd never make it. They'll hunt us down like dogs.
Walder Frey says time to...
Guard this with your life. Return it to Ironrath, where it belongs. There's no time to waste. I'll be damned if I let it fall into the hands of those traitors.
What the Frey says,
you have to go.
You're welcome. Come to the fucking torch.
I will do as you command, my lord.
You have served me well. I know I can count on you. Tell your uncle. Tell him. The North Grove must never be lost. Tell no one but him. Do you understand? You must swear. Tell only your uncle Duncan. The future of the house may depend on it.
I swear that I will, my lord.
Hey, it's those foresters!
Now go. On your honor, you must do this for your house. Go!
Kill those fucking foresters!
With love, the Frey!
So ends the blood soaked in. That should be good. So I just try not to block any significant text or anything. I mean, I know you can see through me a little bit, but... Alright.
Lord! Fresh.
I wanted to mention, just while we're in a quiet moment here, Garrod kind of reminds me of David Tennant. It's not him, but it kind of looks like him a little bit, and kind of sounds like him a little bit, and at first I thought it actually might have been him, but I looked it up and it's not.
That's Father's car.
Lord Bolton better give us fucking titles for this.
Winter may be coming, but at least he'll have his bacon.
Move along, boy. There's nothing for you here.
Father.
I said move on. Unless you want to get fed to the fucking pigs.
I'm going to kill you.
Is that so? You can try if you like.
And then we'll feed you to the pigs.
Get off my land!
This is Bolton land now, boy. Lord Bolton is the new Warden of the North. I reckon he'd like a proper lordly sword like that.
No.
I'll have that sword, boy.
Come get it, you bastard.
Finish this fucking pig farmer.
Pathetic.
You really are a pig farmer.
Some of the fights are a little tricky with the timing. There we go. All right. Yep. Good. I got this.
Mercy! Please! I beg of you! I have a family! They'll never survive without me! I have no quarrel with you! I was only following orders. Thank you!
Lord Whitehill will see you hang for this! That much I promise!
Father?
Garrett! You survived! Your sister! Oh, she hid! I tried to stop them!
I'll kill the men who did this.
It's always a little tricky to find just the right space to put my reaction cam. We'll try down in this corner now and we'll see how that goes. Oh yeah, this definitely seems better. They're putting the titles over there. All right.
It's Garrett! Get the Castellan! Tell him his nephew survived!
Yay.
Garrett!
I was too late. They were already dead.
Bring the Maester! Meet us in the Great Hall! Quickly!
Two White Hill soldiers? And a Bolton.
They killed my family. And for what? My sister, she was only 8 years old.
This never would have happened with the Starks in power. It's unimaginable. Unacceptable. You have my condolences.
Thank you, Maester.
The blade cut deep, but I should be able to save your leg. Your justice was swift. Some will call it vengeance. No doubt the White Hills will claim it was murder. It was your family. I can't say I would have done any different than you. But the White Hills won't see it that way.
It was justice. They got what they deserved.
They did indeed. We can't let the White Hills just walk all over us. These maggots ought to help prevent infection. Hold the wound open for me, would you?
Oh, you guys are gonna love this part. Just sprinkle some maggots in there. That's good.
These are dark days, I fear. To lose the lord of the house and the eldest son through such a despicable act of treachery and betrayal. Greater houses than ours have fallen in times such as this. The late Lord Forrester was a good man. And poor Roderick. A serious man, but he would have made a good lord. The future of this house is in Lord Ethan's hands now, although he is young and altogether unprepared to lead. Right. This might hurt a bit. Hold this for me, will you? I understand from your uncle that Lord Forrester saved your life.
He did.
Rather odd, though, that he chose to save you, his squire, and not his son, Roderick. Not that Roderick couldn't handle himself. He was as good with a sword as any man I've seen. It's unfortunate the Citadel doesn't train maesters in the art of warcraft. I imagine I'd be pretty good with a sword.
Roderick had already fallen. There was nothing we could do.
Well, I'd imagine Lord Forrester would sacrifice himself to save anyone from his house, high or low. Lady Forrester will be here any moment now. I'd like you to walk for me first, to see if you can put any weight on that leg. Go on. Don't stop now. It's better to let the blood circulate.
All right, so walk around. I was just looking at some of the reactions to the maggot scene. most notable was Cass, Toon Man 1984, just as my brother, as most of you know, just as the Telltale Walking Dead game was his introduction to the world of Walking Dead, the Telltale Game of Thrones game is his introduction to Game of Thrones. And his reaction to the maggot scene was just, "Oh God! I'm cringing and my hands are shaking!" Alright, so we're just going to take a little look around here at the stuff in the room. Okay, yeah, so this is basically a family portrait here. So this will give you basically a brief little bit of information about each of the characters in each of the sort of major characters in House Forrester.
Asha. Exiled to Essos, unfortunately.
Okay, very brief information about them.
Talia and Ethan. I suppose Lord Ethan now. Mira. Still in King's Landing, I suppose. Although, I wonder if they'll bring her home.
Ryan. Never easy being the fourth born son. Lord Forrester, it was an honor to squire for him. Gregor the Good. Roderick, he was our best warrior by far.
You seem to be favoring it. Always sad to see a warrior lose a leg.
I'm fine, Maester Otengren. Look, I'll show you.
The Ironwood Grove.
Items we can take or anything like that. No, that's limp, 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 limp. Look at medical supplies. Okay. Look at bucket. Here, Cass, you want to just stick your hand in there?
Rather cute little creatures, aren't they?
I guess.
Talk to the Maester when you've finished exploring. Okay, I will do so.
This might help.
I may be mistaken. You do seem able to put weight on it. Keep moving. I need to see you walk.
Except we finished exploring, so we actually need to talk to you now. I'll show him the sword first.
It's a good thing you've done, bringing that back to House Forrester. By right, that belongs to Lord Ethan now. That sword has been handed down through 50 generations of Foresters. Did your leg feel weak?
No. I just wanted to ask you. Who is the new lord of House Forrester?
Why, Ethan, of course. At the Citadel, I swore an oath to serve whichever noble house I was assigned. Advising the late Lord Forrester was an honor. Advising Ethan, his third-born son, is challenging. There's still so much he has to learn, yet the very fate and future of this house rests in his hands. Which is rather frightening when you think about it.
Why do the White Hills hate the Forresters?
I think it's safe to say the feeling is mutual. There's been enmity between the two houses for as long as anyone can remember. I don't doubt someone killed someone, which led to more killings of someones, and then, well, here we are.
The White Hills want Forrester Ironwood.
They'd take it all if we'd let them, especially now with the Boltons in power, and proceed to clear-cut every last inch of it until there's nothing left, just as they've done before.
What will happen to me now?
Excellent question. Under normal circumstances, you could join Sir Roiland and his men. Although, given the circumstances of your... circumstances, it becomes a bit tricky, doesn't it? I suppose it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
Lord Forrester promoted me. At the Twins, I'm no longer a squire, if that matters.
It might, I suppose. But I'll defer to Lord Ethan on this.
Can I see Ethan? Is he here?
He is. But I'm afraid he's indisposed at the moment. He prefers not to be disturbed while practicing his lute.
Can I go now?
I believe your leg will be fine. Only time will tell, but... Lady Forrester.
Welcome home, Garrett. We're all relieved to know you survived.
Thank you, my lady.
Talia asked to see you.
Garrett, I heard what happened. Is it true? Your family... So sorry.
Mato.
Off to bed now. Hurry on. Garrett was just telling me how valiantly Lord Forrester fought to the end, even when all was lost. I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know. Whatever you can recall.
He saved my life, my lady.
Yet not Roderick's.
You were with Roderick, no? I'm sure it was chaos and confusion. But if you can remember anything, I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
He fought valiantly, my lady.
Of course he did. He was House Forrester's best.
This has been so incredibly difficult for us, especially the children. But I was told you were the last to see my husband alive.
Yes, my lady.
I know it may be difficult to remember, but if I may ask, was there anything he said?
Any last words before he passed? If you can remember. It would mean so much to the family.
He said he loved you.
That's very kind of you to say. You have the Forester's sword.
This belongs with Ethan now. He's the new lord of the house.
Thank you, Garrett.
Of course, my lady.
It demands a response.
It's too dangerous, especially now.
Now is the time to prove our strength.
I'll be sure it's given to Ethan.
Duncan, this was our land. They were our people. Your family.
I share your outrage, Sir Roiland. I do. But now is not the time to provoke the White Hills. Not with Ramsay Snow coming to see us bend the knee.
The hell with Ramsay Snow, the bastard.
Garrett, you understand what this means. You killed a Bolton, and Ramsay Snow will want his retribution.
We're the ones that should be demanding retribution. This happened on Forrester land.
They killed my family.
And they'll pay for what they've done. That much I promise. But now is not the time for vengeance.
If not now, when?
We have to be smart. Ramsay Snow will be here within the week.
And what would you have us do? Nothing.
I would have us use our heads while they're still attached to our shoulders.
Garrett has lost as much as anyone else within these walls. Maybe you can talk some sense into your uncle.
Garrett's suffered enough already. You ask too much of the boy.
He deserves to be heard. It was his family they killed.
My uncle's right. We need to be smart.
Smart. Eddard Stark was smart. And look where that got him. So, what's to be done?
Ultimately, it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
He's just a boy who can barely hold a sword. He knows nothing of how to lead men.
He is the lord of this house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and swear fealty. But now, this... I'll accuse you of murder, and us of protecting you.
The boy was just defending himself.
I'm not faulting him for what he did.
I'd have done the same, as any man would.
I've done nothing wrong!
Not in their eyes. It's just the excuse Ramsay Snow would need to put us to the torch and kill us all.
I'd like to see them try.
I'm afraid it's a risk we cannot take, which is why you cannot stay.
Cannot stay? Duncan. The boy has suffered enough.
But where would I go?
The one place beyond the reach of even House Bolton.
You're sending him to the wall? The boy's done nothing wrong!
Not in the eyes of the Boltons. I'm afraid it's the only solution. Especially now, when the house is so vulnerable.
I'll do what's best for the house. So I'll go. I'm not afraid.
I know it doesn't seem fair. But it is what's best. That settles it, then. You can have my horse, and I'll see you have plenty of food. But we haven't much time. The White Hills will come looking for you.
Duncan just teleported out of the door there.
Word up to me. I'd gladly drive a sword through Lord Whitehill's heart if given a chance. I would. And God's willing, someday I will. But for now, I have House Forrester to consider first. Lord Forrester would be proud that you're putting the interests of the house ahead of your own. Many of Lord Forrester's best men have volunteered for the war. His own great-uncle was a ranger with the Night's Watch.
I'll do what's best.
Which often isn't what's easiest, but necessary nonetheless.
I've been waiting for the right moment to tell you.
What? What is it?
Lord Forrester asked me to give you a message. He said, the North Grove can never be lost.
Sorry, you caught me by surprise. It's not often discussed, if ever.
What is the North Grove?
Most don't even know it exists. They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools, and it's better kept that way. You haven't told anyone else, have you? This is important, Garrett. I need to know the truth.
Of course not. I told no one.
Well done. Lord Forrester was right to put his trust in you. From this day forward, this will be our secret. But soon, I may need your help.
But
I can't say anything more just yet. Just know the North Grove may very well be vital to the future of this house. But don't breathe a word of it to anyone at the wall. Become a ranger if you can. It will help. Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Remember, you represent House Forrester. Your actions at the war will reflect the honor and dignity of the house.
I'll serve with honor.
I know you will.
I should mention, the first time I played this, I wasn't quite sure who I was supposed to give the message to, so I was just telling everyone. And I was like, you betrayed your solemn oath. I'm like, oh, damn it.
Garrett, wait! Be safe. If he were smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game.
You found me! Well done, Ryan. Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game. I don't like it.
He was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asher. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and—
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
I don't want Gerard to die either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the wall. I'll miss Gerard. He was nice.
I don't know what he did to get sent away like that.
He let me ride one of his pigs once. It was fun.
He'll be fine. Gerard is smart.
No one will tell me what Gerard did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
And he calls you a milksop.
Sir Roiland forgets himself. After all, you are the lord of the house now.
He doesn't know me or what I'm capable of.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know, but I know it's not good.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword, like a man. He taught Roderick and Asher, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asher. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. But then, well, then everything changed. Roderick became so serious, the lord in training, and he never smiled anymore. And Asher just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are. I know a lord has many responsibilities, but you don't need to be like them. It's for you to decide for yourself.
I promise I won't change.
Good, because I'd rather have a brother than a lord.
You'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
But since you're the new lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once. But Ethan will be a good lord. A proper lord.
As many as you'd like, yes.
Really?
Of course. Why not?
Lord Ethan,
you have all the
you're
candy.
Needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced, and certainly unexpected.
Oh, dear.
He's come demanding justice.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
If I were Lord, I would command Ethan to stay, with his family. Lord Whitehill is a mean old man anyways. Someone should tell him to leave us alone.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well then.
Such a scene of sweet innocence and innocence lost.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
Your business with Garrod. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrod is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction. Out there, you were decisive and firm. Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
I can handle Lord Whitehill.
Well said, my lord.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got 5 times as many men, and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men roll over.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house, but to his family it's still a loss. My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself.
Oh.
I've been waiting for this day all my life. The Forresters finally get their due.
My father died a hero, fighting for the North against traitors and oathbreakers.
Aye. And look where that got him. And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur.
No courtesies. I should have expected as much. Bloody Foresters.
Fetch Lord Whitehill some bread and salt. It was an oversight, Lord Whitehill. I promise it won't happen again.
Not likely. You Foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have you back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roose Bolton is the Warden of the North.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries, you cunt.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
We all serve House Bolton now.
I'm not finished. Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Your man, the Squire. We were minding our own business, keeping the King's peace, as his lordship here said, when your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
No reason? You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan?
He acted in your name. And you are the Lord of this house.
We lost people too, Lord Whitehill. Your men murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. The soldiers worth 100 of their type. Where's the fucking coward who killed my men?
I know he's here. What have you done with him?
I took care of it. He received his punishment and it's done. He's gone.
What? Gone? That was my justice to deliver, boy, and you denied me of it.
I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton.
What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all. But this is not over.
It's over when my son says it is.
Thank you for coming, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. That the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
You're a craven, Lord Whitehill.
Yeah! Suck it.
I was wrong about your son, my lady. He stood up to him like a true lord.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee. Prepare a raven. We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once. Your sister can help us.
So bright!
Although just a handmaiden, she has Marjorie Tyrell's favor. And Lady Marjorie's betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay. If it's presented to her as it should be.
Okay. Well, look at this. Looking at things. So we got here. We got a high garden brooch.
It was very kind of Lady Marjorie to give this to me. It once belonged to Lady Elena. Ethan made this for me.
Forget her home.
Asher sent me this coin to remember him. What a strange place, Essos.
Okay.
Father, much excitement here in King's Landing for the coming wedding. Lady Marjorie has proven to be quite popular throughout the city. I do wish you and Mother could come, although I know it would be impossible under the circumstances. I miss all of you, and I look forward to the day you can.
Slam. Ow, my fingers! Sorry. I can't be your handmaiden anymore. I crushed my hand in my chest when I was being nostalgic.
Wonders made by man, by Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick. I hope to see them all someday.
Oh, let's check out the view.
King's Landing. I wonder if it's sunny at Ironwrath today.
Okay, no view for us. Only she may see the view. We are not worthy of the view. Letter from Mother. Okay.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally. Especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
To say, I like the art style in this. It's kind of like a watercolor painting come to life, you know. It's very cool.
One moment.
Oh. Sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, it's fine. Come in.
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but you all right? If you don't mind my asking. You seem rather upset.
I'm just worried about my family.
Ah, letter from home, is it?
It's kind of you to ask.
Of course, m'lady. You've always been kind to me.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady. You work for Lady Marjorie? I may be wrong. But it seems like you do.
I'm her handmaiden.
That's what I thought. I've seen you with her before. You seem like good friends. I saw Lady Marjorie just this morning, outside the Royal Sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Cersei?
Anytime Cersei's involved...
They appeared to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear much, but it was definitely an argument.
What did they say?
I couldn't make out much, but I know they were talking about the Starks and House Forrester.
House Forrester?
I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. But I thought you ought to know. Most people don't tend to notice a call boy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see and hear all sorts of things when people don't even know you're there. Good night, m'lady.
Yep.
Lady Marjorie, you're early.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk. Come, there's something we must discuss.
Which would be, I guess it's Varys likes to use the Coalboys. The sort of
from the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining. And your poor family as well.
You're very kind, my lady.
Of course, Mira. But you must not despair. We will get through this together. You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor. She was very pleased with herself. Her face was full of mirth as she said it.
I'm not a traitor.
Of course not. It's only an excuse to torment you, and by extension, me. She demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort, for what I don't know, but... She's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important. I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
I'll do as you ask, my lady.
I knew I could trust you. Humor her. Tell her what she wants to hear.
And that's all the advice you get.
See if the Queen Regent is ready to receive us.
Okay, here we go.
You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
Okay, that's all the advice you get.
Good luck.
So she's telling me to lie on her behalf? God. All right. Here we go. Cersei, easily one of the most intimidating characters in the whole series.
You can do this.
So I was wondering what the time frame. This is, well, obviously just before Marjorie marries Joffrey, and when...
Lady Marjorie. Aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion. Your Grace?
And Tyrion is presently hand to the king.
With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Or he might be Master of Coin at this point, I can't remember.
Your Grace.
The girl knows her courtesies. Impressive.
You may rise.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is. The girl can speak for her house.
Yes, Your Grace. To the one true king.
The one true king. Yet she didn't say which. The girl is clever.
She only meant...
I don't care what she meant.
Temeterian, shut up.
I care what she said. I won't stand for impertinence from a girl of the North.
If you would give her the chance to explain...
Perhaps she can explain why the Foresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark for centuries. A house of traitors.
They were the Wardens of the North. We all served at the pleasure of the king.
Clever girl.
Perhaps too clever for her own good. And she would have believe she didn't know which king she served. Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
He is the Warden of the North, Your Grace.
He is. And I the Queen Regent and Tyrion the Master of Coin.
There we go.
The girl has a remarkable talent for answering questions while in fact saying nothing at all.
Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Yes, Your Grace.
It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
Yes, Your Grace. I would do anything.
I see.
I don't like that that pleased her.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose.
The hell?
Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Marjorie here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
I won't judge her, Your Grace. I wasn't there. I didn't face her decisions.
Aren't you a delightful girl? If only one could flit through life without ever holding an opinion of their own.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the North, here in service to Lady Marjorie. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
God.
I'm sure she
would... Let the girl answer the question.
That's not a...
Go on.
My loyalties would never conflict, Your Grace.
That's a coward's answer. I will not have my time wasted by a northern girl who thinks she can play games. Who do you choose?
Damn it. No time limit on this one.
The king, of course.
Well said. I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
My sense is this girl will say almost anything to get what she wants. Which is not very encouraging.
I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
Now, I've played through this scene a few times in previous playthroughs, and as near as I can figure, there is no way to fully please Cersei.
I'll walk you out.
Like, you're doomed.
This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't dress Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion. That's very kind of you to say.
That certainly took courage. To so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Marjorie was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
I did it for Lady Marjorie.
Rather odd, if that's what she asked of you. But I'm sure she has your best interests at heart. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters. The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard, not her.
What are you suggesting?
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Marjorie might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that? It may be far too dangerous. In fact, forget I even suggested such a thing.
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion. Please.
You are a brave girl, aren't you? I'll consider it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. Three beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
Good night, Lord Tyrion.
Just be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Yay, we get to scheme and plot with Tyrion. I love it. I just love that they put that in as an aspect of the game. You get to scheme and plot with Tyrion.
Mira, I was worried. How was it? Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing. It's more than a little intimidating.
It didn't go very well.
I'm sorry. Cersei is known for being rather difficult. But at least it's over now. Lady Marjorie has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back, here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Sir Jaime, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah!
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour, which I doubt is Dornish for wife.
He is quite handsome.
And quite passionate, from what I've heard. Perhaps Lady Marjorie could make the right introductions. Who knows, we might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen? He does have a certain look about him, and he's always treated Lady Marjorie well, which is more than you can say for his mother.
I'd marry anyone if it helped my family.
Right, of course. Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden. Let's see, who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match. Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well? Sarah?
I'm sorry, my lady. As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was pleased by your display, Mira.
Oh, good.
I'm just glad it's over.
I'm surprised, but I'm good.
King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am Queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
People are not always so easy to please. If you showed Cersei your true heart, she would stab it with a fork.
You learn very quickly.
That's a good line.
Your words to Cersei were brave, but I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important. I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her. Go on. Ask.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought, if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
That is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise. But my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire?
You can't, my lady. King Joffrey won't like it. Just think how he turned on Lady Sansa. I will forever be in your debt. My family will forever be in your debt.
I don't know, Mira. If Cersei were to find out...
You're the only one who can help me. You have power over him, Lady Marjorie, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
Well, damn. That actually went better than the last time I played. Last time I played, she politely refused. I was like, damn it. I actually thought there was no way to convince her to help, but I sit corrected. Oh, shit. Oh, no. Where the hell is he?
Seven elves.
I am loyal to your father. I am loyal to have both, please. No, play a little game, shall we? Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat?
Oh, God.
Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy, what with all that bloody noise.
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets. But the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father is the Warden of the North.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
My lord?
Shh! Listen. There. Hear that? I know I heard something. Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
That's Ramsay, in case you were wondering, the one they keep talking about. For anyone who didn't know that. The one everyone is dreading. And now maybe you can see why.
Bloody hell!
No, Mystic, I mentioned at the beginning it's not my first time playing this.
Lord Ethan!
I played the first three episodes before, but not...
As I was saying... You are young, and there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forester Lords stand behind you. Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good. He was fair and wise, and courageous in battle.
I want to be like that, like my father.
Your father was well regarded by nearly everyone. That took years, if not decades, to earn. These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others. The Lord Sentinel. Forester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore. Move! Summon the Lord! We need his judgment!
Oh, shit.
I've done nothing wrong! I was only trying to survive!
Lord Ethan.
Maester.
Who is this man?
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed! We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
two shields and three spears.
Is what Sir Roylan said true?
Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks true.
I've a family to feed, and not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Mercy. Go.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter. Most of us won't even live to see it.
We are in this together.
You say that, but it won't be you who starve in come winter.
You'll address him as Lord.
Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it is.
Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their lord will not permit it.
He's a thief.
We can send him to the war.
Leave the man alone. Show him mercy, my lord. He stole from us. He deserved to.
Mercy.
Make him pay for what he's done.
Give us justice.
Fuck him.
I will decide.
Send him to the war.
Leave the
poor man. Take his fingers.
He's a thief. If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord. Please, my lord. My family depends on me.
Decisions, decisions, decisions. I don't know, I don't see anybody offering any suggestions, so I guess it's up to me. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe, da 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 da.
Our house tends to its people. See, this man is paid and his family is fed.
Lord Ethan, you are truly a merciful and noble lord.
My lord, this man is a criminal. A brazen thief.
He still serves House Forrester and deserves our protection.
He's a rat in our grain stores.
My lord, we must speak about our gold reserves. Soon.
My lord, I thank you for the mercy you've shown me. I will never forget my debt to you and to this house.
Everyone else is saying fingers. Toon Man says, oh, you bleeding heart. You had a family!
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due.
Not just yourself, of course. It can weigh on any lord.
Maester, what do you think?
Me?
Yes. Did I do what's right?
Disloyalty shouldn't be rewarded if others will take advantage of your mercy. You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side. Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance. Possessing wisdom and experience.
Who do you think I should choose?
There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here. The bracer of the Sentinel. The badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen Sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your Sentinel will wear this for all to see.
I'll make the right choice as Sentinel.
Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
All right. Let's do this. They're both like, you're gonna pick me, right? Yeah, you're gonna pick me, right? Huh? Totally gonna pick me, right? we don't need to go to the tower. We don't need to talk to him. We'll go over there in a minute. I want to talk to the little kid over here first. Look at Ryan. Oh, he's making a sword. That's adorable.
Careful. Keep at it and you won't have much left. Something to pick your teeth with.
No, Ethan. Look at this. All good swords have a name. I call mine Two Brothers. I carved this to give me strength. And this, so I remember.
Aww.
I mean, I could never forget. But, you know, don't you?
You honor Roderick with this. He was a strong one.
He was. Yeah. Someday, I'll have a real one. But not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
You'll have a good sword. I'm sure of it.
I watched you today. I saw what you did to that man. Was he our enemy? A bad man? Everyone keeps talking about them. Enemies. Talia told me what it means.
No, he's not our enemy, but he did a bad thing.
Then I wish you'd hurt him. People who do bad things need to be punished.
Well, damn.
Someone did something bad to Father and Roderick. Someone should hurt them even worse. I want a real sword. No one's afraid of wood. I'll find the men who took Roderick someday, and I'll make sure I have a real sword when I do.
So even the little kid wanted me to chop the guy's fingers off.
Do it like you mean it.
Look at portcullis. Fuck this, I'm out of here. Ooh, see, nice view there. Why don't we get a view of King's Landing? Alright, can't talk to them. Alright. Well, let's talk to Sir Roiland.
Come on, what did I say? Swords up, slash right, parry, again. Sword up, swing left, parry. Wrong. I didn't know
Sir
dogs
Roiland.
Could hold swords.
Wrong.
Of course, my lord.
Wrong.
I have many decisions to make, and I wanted your advice. What's the state of our defences? Are these men ready for what's coming?
This lot, ready? No, but they will be. We post anyone who can hold a spear along the parapet, up where they won't get much scrutiny, and put our meanest, nastiest-looking brutes front and centre. That'll show Ramsay we're a force in our own right. You've got to project power, especially when you're weakened.
Thank you, Sir Roiland. I'll let you get back to training these men.
Thank you, my lord. And I'll be sure to watch out for more deserters. After today, I suspect there'll be more to come. Yes, my lord?
I need to name a sentinel.
Ah, you do. And it's good you came to me. I know this house, and everyone here knows me. They know I can hold the reins or wield the sword in equal measure. I'm the man you need. And might I remind you, it was Duncan Tuttle who sent Garrett to the wall. He undermined your authority and made you look weak to the White Hills. I would never do that to you. And if you pardon me saying so, I think your father would be proud, seeing you make good choices as a young lord.
I haven't made my decision yet, but I appreciate your opinion.
So, when will you declare your decision, my lord?
Tonight, at the small council meeting.
Very good. I trust your judgment, my lord.
All right, so we'll get over here. Oh, who's this guy? Malcolm. Don't mind me, I'm just looking at you and stuff.
Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
I saw what you did today. It's not an easy thing to do, showing mercy to a man who admits his guilt. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow, at first light.
But where are you going?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him, to help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, that I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted. I will hold, of course, until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
She's my mother. Of course I'll be gentle.
I know you will. You're good-hearted, my lord. That is your true strength.
But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job. He'd be a fine choice. And I'd trust him. Aye, Sir Roiland is the man you want.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
Ethan, I need to talk to you.
Well, I was actually just going to come and talk to you, but sure.
Mother told me Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrod being sent to the wall without my knowledge.
I know! And that wasn't your fault.
But I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What? Ethan, please. Tell me.
Who should I name as my sentinel?
It should definitely be Duncan Tuttle. He's dependable and smart, and everyone trusts his judgment. Sir Roiland is unpredictable and likely to make matters worse.
You've always given me good advice. Thank you.
That's great. So, 50-50 split. Thanks, other people. You are useless. Where the heck is Duncan? Oh, there he is. Hold on, we're gonna look at the food first. Look at food!
Our provisions are rather low, my lord. I made the count again, just to be sure.
Has anything gone missing?
No. Doesn't look that way. Seems Eric was the only one to resort to thievery. But I'm still worried about our stores. We couldn't withstand a siege, my lord. If the Boltons or the White Hills cut us off and wait us out, we'd only last a fortnight. But there are steps we can take. In the past, we've demanded food from the small folk to replenish our stores. We can do it again, if you'd like. We've done it before in desperate times. The last long winter, my family had to give all our pigs to the house.
If that's what's necessary to keep the house safe, then we must.
Aye, a hard choice, but it's what has to be done. I'll see to the arrangements, my lord.
Yeah, in the meantime, just checking you out there, Duncan. All right, good, looking good.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role?
Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
Actually, I wanted to ask, why did you send Garrett away?
I did it for your own protection, my lord. Garrett had to go. By sending him away myself, I thought it would keep you blameless in the eyes of the White Hills. I only hope to give you an advantage, and I regret any action you disapprove of.
I understand, and you're forgiven.
Thank you, my lord.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
That everything? All right, good. Good enough. I am satisfied with the useless advice that everybody gave me. Where's Meister, Meisterburger? Here he is. Go look at him. Okay. What? Just thank you. Stroke it. Yeah. Oh, feels nice. Oh, yeah. That's good. Yeah. One more time. Oh, yeah. There we go. That's good. Maybe one more. Oh, so gentle. You must use palm olive when you do dishes. You have such soft hands. All right,
Maester.
Here we go.
Yes, Lord Ethan. I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
What is it you're doing over here?
Admiring the ironwood, my lord. I studied it at the Citadel. The wood may be black, but I see gold. An entire forest of gold.
What do you mean?
It is our greatest asset, my lord. Why not give some of our ironwood to House Bolton and have them leave us be? We could ransom ourselves. You can hardly put a price on your own life, or the lives of those you love.
Ransom or a robbery? We may pay him now, but what's to stop him from coming back again?
Lord Ethan, the dangers of today outweigh the fears of tomorrow.
The needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few. No, I'm not finished talking to you.
My lord, are you now ready to name your sentinel?
Yes.
Yes, Maester. I'm ready.
Very well.
I have made a decision.
I will convene a small council at once.
Based on all of the useless advice that I have gathered that helped me not at all in any way whatsoever, I have come to a completely misinformed and possibly misguided decision. Let us convene the small council. Yeah. Duncan Large is very excited that one of the people that can be chosen is named Duncan. He's like, choose Duncan. He can make tea. Everyone needs a Duncan.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you. Duncan, Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
Yes,
let him be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made my decision.
And I give it to Ryan! Sweet little Ryan! He will be my sentinel! No. Ryland. Or Duncan. Sir Ryland. Or Duncan. Sir Ryland. Well, see, don't know if I can choose Sir Roiland because it's spelled S-E-R, and that just doesn't sit right with me. So I'm gonna have to go with Duncan.
Duncan Tuttle, you will be my sentinel.
Tuttle, this is reckless.
Lord Ethan has made his choice. I will not disappoint you, my lord.
Now, Sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
Our scout says only a day's ride from here, with no time to waste.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword.
That's bloody suicide. You gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls.
Ignore Sir Roiland. You named me Sentinel.
I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This is the bloody small council. Lord Ethan deserves to hear from all of us.
Enough! Would my father have stood for this kind of bickering? Neither will I.
Sir Roiland is clearly able and ready to take up arms, but the rest of our soldiers are not. We need to take a cunning approach. Diplomacy can be a sharper instrument than a sword.
The Bolton sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand.
Gentlemen, please. Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf, but we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help us.
Mother, what do you recommend we do?
We must give him whatever he wants and be done with it. It's too dangerous to do otherwise.
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah. The wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough!
We will fight, we will bargain, we will use... Oh, God. Well, there's no way we can fight them. There's just no fucking way. So, bargain or diplomacy.
My new sentinel favors a certain approach, and I agree. I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow. Right. I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival. Invite him into this hall, and meet him face to face, lord to lord.
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd. You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze upon Ironwrath. And when he enters, he'll know it's only because you allowed it.
Lord Ethan?
Invite him in, or make him wait. Invite him in, or make him wait.
I will meet him at the gate.
Very good, my lord. I shall prepare the men.
Yes.
Men? We hardly have any. It's a foolish plan.
How many years have I served this house? I cannot listen to that bloody idiot anymore. Forgive me, my lord, but you are not ready to be lord of this house. You're likely to get us all killed.
Sit down at once.
Fine.
Apologies, my son. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow at the gate, and we will not offer our ironwood.
And don't worry, Lord Ethan. I will stand beside you, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
Okay. I don't know if that was the best course of action, but I guess we'll find out.
You have named your sentinel, but you still seem conflicted. And no matter what, you can't be indecisive. Not if you want to help this house.
Damn it.
Forgive me.
There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family. Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back.
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister. And we need all the help we can get.
Yes, I hear what you're saying.
Do you remember the Miller's boy? How he tormented you? I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the Miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious, but you were in danger and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities, but you do not have that anger inside you. It's something we could use.
I'm not like that, but I don't need to be, do I?
No, but you need someone who is standing beside you. I'm trying to do what's best for this family, what this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
Fine. Malcolm will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
Thank you, Ethan. I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a forester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Aha! Meanwhile, in King's Landing...
Marjorie?
Hmm.
Oh. Lady Marjorie is still with the king. I thought you'd want to know.
Thank you.
Mira, look. The other day when you asked Lady Marjorie for help, I only spoke out of fear for her. I want to help you if there's anything I can do. Your poor family. I can't imagine how you must feel.
You're sweet to offer, Sarah. Thank you.
Lady Marjorie is always saying how important friends and allies are in King's Landing. Just know, I will be here for you if you ever...
Uh-oh.
My lady, I'll leave you to talk.
That doesn't look good.
Are you all right, my lady?
Th- The king was not inclined to offer help for your family. I'll need this mended.
Gods.
He said I was too easily swayed. And he reminded me that I am not yet his wife. I allayed his fear. For now. But it will be a long time before I can ask him for anything again. Nothing I said could cheer him. He wouldn't even speak to me when I left him.
What can I do to make this better, my lady?
There's nothing you can do, Mira.
Understand, it was my mother's plan, not mine. I just hope you can find some way to forgive me.
This is simply not how things are done, Mira. Not in King's Landing.
I'm sorry, my lady.
Soon I will be queen, and maybe then I'll be in a better position to help you. But for now, we must both be cautious.
I must send a raven. I have to warn my family, if you'll excuse me, my lady.
M'lady. Begging your pardon, m'lady. I hope I didn't frighten you.
How long have you been waiting there?
Not long. I was just passing by when I saw you emerge from Lady Marjorie's room. I hope you saw. I was right before. About Lady Marjorie and Queen Cersei. I just want you to know, I can help you if you'd like. And your family, if you're willing to trust me. I hear all sorts of things. Things that could be useful for you.
How can you help me? My problems can't be solved by what you might overhear.
Which is why you must trust me, m'lady. You need allies. Hopefully I've proven I can be useful to you.
I'm sorry. I really must go.
Please don't despair. I know people who... be willing to help you.
What? Stop staring. My eyes are up here. Because that's basically what that.
Where's Sir Roydon? The man values pride more than honor. And without King's Landing, I know you'd hoped Mira could help us. But I'm confident we've enough strength of our own. Your men stand ready to act if needed.
Our plan is a good one. It will work so long as everyone does their part.
Bolton men approaching, my lord!
Something wrong with your gate? Well, aren't you the little lord? No wonder you can't open the gate. Shall we help you? Now let me in. This is a lovely pile of timber, isn't it?
You're welcome inside, but your men are not.
Did you hear that, men? The Lord of the House says, fuck off. I think he's afraid of you. Wait here. For now.
A token for the new Warden of the North.
Let me guess. Forrester Iron.
Carved by our most skilled craftsman.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much. Don't know what's so special about it.
No one can match our skill.
Is that so? Not bad. Lord Whitehill, can your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn.
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently. Quite the army you have, Lord Forrester. Very impressive.
Choose our words very, very carefully with Ramsay.
Look at that! More foresters.
Lord Ramsay?
Come out where I can see you.
We really must focus on the business at hand.
What is it you want, Lord Ramsay?
What do I want? Everything. Nothing. We'll see. First, let's see you bend the knee to my father, Lord Bolton, Warden of the North. Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal. I want you to show me.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now, was it? Here's the thing. I don't care about your loyalty. The Crown, however, wants what you've got. Whatever you've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships, shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the King. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you? That wouldn't reflect well on me.
You needn't worry. Your father will have what he needs.
That's a good little lord.
You can't trust a forester. They murdered our men.
It was a forester squire who did it. One Whitehill soldier dead. One Bolton. Yet your man lived.
He was within his right. They killed his family.
His right? He killed a loyal soldier in my father's army. You had me stand out in the wind and muck so you could show off your pathetic little army. That sort of insolence from one of our loyal bannermen will not do. So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone. The Whitehills will be taking control of your Ironwood from this day forward.
What?
What? The Ironwood. But...
That is our livelihood.
Then you'd better well find another fucking job.
You can't do that.
Why not? You know something the Whitehills don't? We are talking about trees. You grow them, you cut them down. It can't be that difficult.
The Whitehills had Ironwood, once, but now those hills are bare.
Hence the name. Of course.
They know nothing of how to cultivate the forest.
Look at their sigil, my lord. A barren hill.
Do you want ironwood for the next 5 years, or the next 50 generations?
The little lord does have a point. We'll try this. Lord Whitehill will take half of your ironwood, and we'll see who fares better.
But my lord...
Half of something is better than the nothing you had before. To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls.
At Ironwrath, that we cannot abide. Ethan!
They'll help maintain the king's peace. And make sure there's no more trouble.
This will cause more trouble, not less.
Not for me.
Mm-hmm. Well, shit.
You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
Griff will lead the garrison.
You have no right. Whitehills have no place here.
Lads, do make this visit worthwhile.
Please, Duncan, don't.
Look at this, little forester. You're not frightened, are you?
Lord Ramsay, please.
And you? Are you Lord Ethan's older sister?
I'm his twin, my lord.
Oh, twins. Well, like the Queen and her brother. Well, hopefully not just like the Queen and her brother. I never had a sister. Always wanted one.
Leave my sister alone!
I have an idea. You'll come with me. You can be my highborn ward.
Lord Ramsay, that's enough.
Do you like hunting?
Let her go.
She's quite pretty, your sister. We'd get along well. I suppose you can stay. Aren't you the bold lord?
Ethan! No!
What have you done?
No!
But I don't want a bold lord. Far too much trouble.
Ethan! Ethan! No!
Bastard!
Even though you did bend the knee.
Son,
I think we've come to an understanding.
Lord Ethan!
I certainly feel better about all this.
Ethan. What have you done?
However, the foresters need to keep their end of the bargain. Take the boy as your ward.
No!
Kill him if they give you any trouble.
Brian!
Lovely meeting all of you.
We'll have to do it again sometime.
Somebody help him!
Fetch the maester quickly!
You brought this on yourself.
Mana!
Stop!
Don't let him take me!
Let him go!
Stop that!
Help me!
Brian,
stop it!
Let me go!
Brian!
Do something!
Ethan? My son.
In case you're wondering, no, there's no way for Ethan not to get stabbed in the throat in that scene. Believe me, I've tried.
Ethan sacrificed himself for us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
This house needs a leader.
Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you did it without flinching.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us. Those who hold House Forrester above all other loyalties. Those who will not stop until Ethan is avenged. Until Ryan is home again, our house will not fall. We will be ready.
Nothing comes without a cost, my lady. Are you prepared for what might happen?
Episode 1, Iron from Ice. Let's see how our decisions went. You and 66.2% stayed with Bowen. That was the other squire at the beginning. You and 62.3% swore loyalty to the king. You and, wow, 48.6% freed Eric. So the others, that was almost fully half. So the other two decisions made up the second half there. That's interesting. I wonder what the percentage is on those. You and 69.4% picked Duncan as Sentinel. A lot of Duncan fans out there. And almost an even split. You and 50.3% met Ramsay at the gate. And there we go. Yeah, the that scene with Ramsay is always tense. I played through that scene a few different ways. Actually, interestingly enough, this is the first time I ever decided to try meeting him at the gate. The previous time I played, I met him in the Great Hall. The end result is the same. It always ends up in the Great Hall regardless. And Ethan still ends up with a knife in his throat. But, yeah, what can you do? but I kind of like the fact that it pissed Ramsay off more by meeting him at the gate. So I do like any opportunity to annoy Ramsay. But all the things that were necessary to accomplish there, like convincing them not to give the full Ironwood thing over to the White Hills, that was successful. So that's good. That's a good thing. All right. I think we have ending credits here. We have silent ending credits. Okay. Oh, so I noticed Cass left just before the final scene of the episode. Like, literally, there was literally like 10 minutes left, and he left. He left right before the big, shocking ending of the episode. Way to go, Cass! He couldn't hold out for 10 more minutes. Oh well, whatever. So, yeah, pretty good stuff. Obviously, not a lot of action in that episode, simply because it necessarily has a shit ton of introduction. Oh, you can see all the cast there. Because, I mean, this is our first introduction to the Foresters and sort of their house and what they have to do and stuff like that. And how they kind of fit in with all the other stuff. But pretty cool. Yeah, I definitely, it definitely grabbed me the first time I saw it, so much so that after playing the first episode, I immediately bought the season pass for all six episodes. I was like, yep, I'm sold. So I do have all six episodes. That's kind of why I waited so long to do the playthrough of it, as I wanted to have all six parts, so we could just kind of do them all back to back. So, yeah, I hope you all enjoyed that. I think we're almost at the... Boy, these credits seem to go a lot faster than the Walking Dead ones did. Roger Waters the Fish. Interesting. Yeah. So, and odd that they're silent. Well, I guess silent in deference to the, shocking death at the end there. And we'll just stop there, apparently. All right. I think it just goes back to the menu at this point. Come on. Come on. The gears of the great clock turn ever onward. Ah, there we are. Ah, yes. So episode 2, which we'll check out next time. Excellent. Garrett arriving at the wall, and more intrigue with Mira and King's Landing, and all kinds of other good stuff, which we'll find out about next time. Alrighty, folks, so that is it for episode 1 of Telltale Games Game of Thrones. We'll see you next time for more. I'm not sure when we'll be doing episode 2, maybe soonish. We'll see. But anyway, those of you watching on YouTube, you can look forward to episode 2 next Monday. And those of you on Twitch, you can look forward to it whenever. Alrighty. That is it for me to you for now. So thank you very much for watching. By the way, for those of you who have a fear of commitment and don't want to sign up for Patreon but still want to throw money at me occasionally, I've added a donation button to the Twitch page there. So feel free if you, you know, on a whim just want to throw some money my way. So there you go. Alrighty. See you next time. Till then, thanks for watching and sayonara.